AstraZeneca-Oxford vaccine appears to greatly reduce COVID-19 spread. Experts warn people about easing on health protocols after getting vaccinated. This is because they cannot tell whether vaccines can decrease transmission. However, the AstraZeneca-Oxford vaccine seems capable of it, according to a preprint released on The Lancet. Researchers at the University of Oxford analyzed further data from the ongoing Phase 3 clinical trials. They determined that the vaccine efficacy was higher at longer intervals between the primary dose and the booster. For the single dose, the vaccine was calculated 76% efficacious from 22 to 90 days after vaccination. That was based on additional 201 cases of symptomatic COVID-19 they reviewed. With an interval of fewer than 6 weeks, the vaccine efficacy was only 54.9%. But with 12 weeks or more, the interval yielded an efficacy rate of 82.4%. The 76% efficacy rate against symptomatic COVID-19 could be achieved 90 days post-vaccination, though the immune system will require 22 days to completely build the protection. According to CNN, researchers didn't directly measure the transmission in the study. What suggested it was the COVID-19 positivity rate in tests. The team had to collect swab samples frequently from some participants to assess the vaccine's performance. The samples were then tested using RT-PCR, and details were added to the clinical trial data. Analyzed samples unveiled that positive tests dropped by 50% after 2 doses, yet just 1 dose axed the positivity rate by 67%. Researchers wrote, "While transmission studies per se were not included in the analysis, swabs were obtained from volunteers every week in the UK study, regardless of symptoms." The role of the AstraZeneca vaccine in reducing transmission isn't absolute yet. Researchers clarified that their findings provided a proxy, which indicated the potential. In other words, if the vaccine had no impact on asymptomatic COVID-19, severe cases should simply be turned into mild, and mild cases to asymptomatic. The positivity rate from PCT tests would be unchanged, and yet, something changed the rate and they have to find it. Dr. Doug Brown, chief executive of the British Society for Immunology, agreed that the findings are good news. But until the data is formed, the public needs to maintain safety guidelines after vaccination. For other experts, the details unearthed by researchers are a starting point in understanding how vaccination may interfere with SARS-CoV-2 transmission. It's also an excellent starting point for Pfizer, BioNTech, Moderna, Sinopharm, Gamaleya, and other vaccine makers.